As an entry to my 250 subs competition back then, Putty Boy Studios sent me in this Chaos Knight and asked me to paint it in a Tsiinch color scheme. So I hope this finds your pleasure. And if you want to see how I painted this, please enjoy the following video. As usual, this video has been produced by
Nerdopolis Prime.
This guy somehow looks like a Tsiinch guy, especially if you take a closer look at the helmet, because it's got that that all-seeing eye on the top, just here. So, but I will first start with the horse. Painting some dark highlights and then shading it with the Agrax Earthshade. In the meanwhile, the Agrax Earthshade is drying. I will go for the fur and I will apply some Bubonic Brown and then shade it with Seraphim Sepia to give it a little bit more of a fleshy shade tone. The shades are still drying, so I cannot go for the skin of the horse. Instead, I will go for the tongue of the horse. As you can see, the mouth is open and it's sticking out his tongue. I will put a layer of Naggarot Knight on the tongue, and then highlight it with Corn Red and. Where is this? Oh, Mephiston Red. So, it should be a little bit of a Tsiinchy, sick-looking tongue. Instead of highlighting the tongue with the Mephiston Red, I highlighted it with the Phoenix Red, just to give it a little bit more of a shiny touch. Here, on the mount's eyes, or where the eyes should be, there is this, Chaos symbol. I painted that with Corn Red first, and then put in a little bit of a little dot of Phoenix Red. So I hope to achieve some nice and shiny, glowing eyes effect. So now the skin on the horse is dry. Now I can work my way up with again applying some dark highlight. I will thin this down a little bit in order to make this, the skin colors melt into each other. Now, this is going really, really well. Instead of getting to the next, or instead of proceeding to the next color, this time I'll do something different. Commando Khaki should be the last color I am using on this model, but first I will mix it with the dark highlights, the color I used previously, and then I will apply just a soft highlight edging or edge highlighting on the whole skin. So, dark highlights, mix of dark highlights and Commando Khaki, and then Commando Khaki as a last highlight. And here we go. Here you can see the wonderful and nice transition on the skin of the horse. Oops, okay. The other side here. And it gives him a little bit of a sick look. So, for the next thing, we're gonna go for all the fur and the hair and so on. And I will apply the base color again, which was Bubonic Brown. And then I will highlight it as soon as I find another color with which to mix Bubonic Brown and highlight the whole thing properly. So I applied our base color again, which was Bubonic Brown, and then I got an idea. As this guy will end up as a Tsiinch Knight, I remembered that The two main colors of Tsinch is blue and yellow. So as this is some kind of a yellowish fur, I will go over it now. I will apply some highlighting with sun yellow. And if that is not enough, then I will also apply a little bit of lemon yellow to that. So let me apply the sun yellow first, then I'll come back with the result. Alright, sun yellow was enough. Now you can see I'm trying to paint this guy on a little bit of a higher standard. As we said, yellow and blue are the main colors, and that's the perfect excuse for me to grab my most favorite color, which is gunmetal blue. So, now everything that would be metal on this guy, well, almost everything, will be painted in gun blue metal, and when that's when I've applied that that first shade, well, actually, let me show you how it looks when the first layer is applied. And here we go, gunmetal blue. Woohoo! That's my most favorite metal color. this looks so Tsinchy, so great. Now, this time I won't apply any what's this thing called? Noun oil. But first I am going to get my gunmetal blue and some mithril silver, mix that. I think about 50-50 or whatever will come up best, and apply some highlighting. And then when that's done, I will go for mithril silver as a edge highlighting thing. So, I really like this miniature already right by now. Although I've made some minor mistakes here, so nothing spectacular. I've missed out that behind the or under the armor there are some parts I will have to paint afterwards. Yeah, it's not a mistake where you would say, oh, this has completely ruined my whole process of making steps within painting. But yeah, in the end, I hope I will make everything and then it will be all right. Or so I hope. So, but now, gunmetal blue plus mithril silver, and then edge highlighting with mithril silver, pure as it is. And this is it. Our gunmetal blue properly highlighted. This looks like pure magic. So it could be kind of magic armor, something like that. But we've got that bluish tone going on, and this is that is just so perfect. So for the next thing is we've got the blue in there. We want to go for something yellow, and okay. And as we are just painting the armor, all the metal stuff, as a yellow color, I will choose Retributor armor, which then I will shade with the Seraphim Sepia. So, see you in a second when that's done. Oh yeah, and of course, I will leave some parts. I mean, some of those metal things. I will not paint everything in gold. Some of those I want just to have in pure, good old metal. Now, in the meanwhile, the shade is drying. We will go for the bone parts, which are, of course, down here at the hooves and the two skulls here and on the other side, and this skull as well as the horns here and here. By the way, this is the other side. Where is it again? Okay, here it is, this one. So when I've applied Ushtabi bone as the first layer of skull color, I will go then over that with the Agrax Earthshade. I want to use my time as good as I can, and in the meanwhile the shade is drying again. I used, where is it, terracotta in order to paint all the other stuff, like here on his stuff. He's got some some things going on here. The thing for the saddle for his feet, the saddle itself, then down there the belt, which is fixing the saddle on the horse, and such little things. Our next thing to do is go over that with tan flesh, give it a little bit more organic look. Oh yes, and of course I've applied that bone color, and I forgot to mention that of course I'm using the same color on the teeth of the steed. So when I'm done with applying tanned flesh now, I hope the shades will be done, and then we can proceed. Okay, I highlighted the stuff here with a little bit of flesh color, but now it's time for gold again. So back to Retributa armor, and with this we will highlight all the gold parts we have previously shaded. So see you in a second when that's done. Now I'm done with the gold. You could go on and highlight that gold again with the color I can't remember the name of, by Games Workshop, one of the newer colors. I think it came with the Retributa armor, which I just can't remember the name right now. So, next thing for me is to proceed to the skulls. I will again use Ushtabi bone, and then I will highlight that with, oh here it is, with the Screaming Skull. So, see you in a second. Alright, we are nearly done. Only thing to do is the shield over here with that fleshy thing going on, and all the metal parts, all those parts which belong to, or which belong painted in metal, but which we will we have left unpainted until now. So no matter with which color I will end up the highlights, the starting color, the starting color will be Lead Belcher. So here we go, and after I applied Lead Belcher, of course I will go over that with Nuln Oil, and as soon as Nuln Oil is dry, I will go, in the meanwhile the Nuln Oil is drying, I will go for the shields. So now the shade is drying slowly, very slowly, and in the meanwhile I get a phone call, not now. In the meanwhile I painted some Bugman's Glow on the shield here, there we can see that skin type of thing on there, and now I think I will apply a little bit of red ink there, just to give it a little bit of a almost living shade. I don't know, actually I won't give that red ink on there, I'll go for Seraphim Sepia. Okay, and then we'll go for the metal when the metal is dried. Now I have applied Lead Belcher again, and now the next steps are applying Iron Breaker on some parts, followed by Mithril Silver on some other parts. For example, this chainmail over there, I painted with Lead Belcher, followed by Nuln Oil, and then a little bit of lead belcher. So the chainmail, for example, is finished. All the spike is, things will have iron breaker and mithril silver, and some other parts like here will just receive some iron breaker. So see you in a second when that's done. Hey ho, silver! The silver is applied and it looks fancy. Now the last thing to do is the shields. So first of all, I want to go for the skin before then painting all the eyes in there. To do the skin, I will go for Bugman's Glow again and then mix it with a color I still have to decide. I think it will be a normal skin color, but we will see that in the end. And this is the finished shield. So we've got base color Lead Belcher, not Lead Belcher, Bugman's Glow, with the shade, then Bugman's Glow again, and then I built the color up, mixing more and more bronze flesh into the Bugman's Glow. And for the eyes, which are shining out here, I first used golden yellow, then made a line in the eyes with bad moon yellow. So you can see it gets lighter and lighter and lighter. And this and the last thing was just a dot of lemon yellow. So this gives the whole thing a little bit of a living leathery look. So last thing to do is the base, and then we're done with this beauty. And here is our finished Tsinch buddy, the Tsinch Rider Chaos Knight. There you go. Now, this was again real fun to paint, so thank you very much for this miniature. This was just really, really, really very, very enjoyable. So, Putty Boy Studio, this was a great thing. Thank you very much. So, still a few miniatures to go, so please stay tuned. Yeah, and thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.